Kayak anglers don't need to be told what a powerful exploration tool their boat is. This video chronicles the research and exploration of a smallmouth creek in Pennsylvania.
Yo!
Hey man, have you ever fished Patunka Creek?
Where's that?
I was up at a conference near Smithsburg and I was driving over it on the way home. I was really upset I didn't have a rod in the car at the time.
I've never heard of it. Let me look it up on Flash Earth. What town did you say it was near?
I think I just passed Lewistown and the creek joined the river about 10 miles up from there.
Yep, Lewistown. Here it is. Yeah, the topo around it looks good. Lots of ridge lines crossing it. Man, you know there's ledge trenches all around this. How wide did you say it was where you crossed it?
From what I could tell, it was bigger than the Monocacy, but not as wide as the Juniata.
Let me check out the average stream flow on the USGS. Uh-huh. Yeah, it's a nice-sized creek. Average CFS is about 200-230. Let me see what Gertler says about it. Yep, here it is. Gradient's about 5. Difficulty, he says, is 1. He covers about 25.5 miles of it. Here's the trip description. The creek now meanders through a changing landscape, evolving from open, tidy farmlands at first. The creek works down into a shallow, wooded gorge. All along the banks are higher now and often lined by a screen of box elder, sycamore, and silver maple. Though the path is still simple, there are now many riffles to speed along the way. You must carry a 3-foot dam above PA Route 789, a 5-foot dam below State Road 2034 has largely crumbled, but the debris and rebar that clogged the chute will justify a carry, at least at lower levels. Hazards, it says, you know, those two dams he mentions. Water conditions, canoeable winter and spring within 4 days of hard rain. If it rains Thursday like it's supposed to, we should be able to run this. Maybe we'll do one of the further downstream runs where it's bigger.
Okay, Saturday, 6:30. Sounds good. We'll see you then. Bye.
I think this is it. Where do you think we... I think we park. Look at that. Oh, there's Paul over there. He's parked at that church. There's our put-in though. Look at that. Looks pretty. All right, we're here at the put-in with Paul and Roy. And we have some of our real basic tools of exploration. The first one is a Pennsylvania Atlas and Gazetteer. They make these for all the states. And this will show you some of the primary and secondary roads used to run the shuttle. A second very useful tool is the paddling guide for the state that you're exploring. Here we're using Edward Gertler's Keystone Canoeing, and it shows, it basically simplifies your shuttle routes so that you don't have to look at all of the roads in the area. You can just look at the ones that connect to the float that you want to do. It also shows your access points, put-ins, takeouts, the distances between bridges and access points. What else were you guys able to find just to, in your research in this piece of water?
I went on Google and punched up the name of the creek we're fishing or wanted to explore, and got some information from a Pennsylvania water trail map that you can see here, and it shows pieces of the creek, and it also has a listing of various put in and take out points, which was good. And then from that, I can go on any given map and look up the information.
Paul, you found that too. Show us what you did with that.
I also got the water trail map, and I was able to, fortunate enough to be able to laminate it, so take it with me on the trip, so there's no fear of getting wet. And I was also able to get the Google map of the creek as well, with the terrain elevation, so you can also see that, and as well as cross streets to, for easy put in and take out.
That's a topo map.
Yes.
How do you use that? I mean, how is that better than just the regular water trail map?
Well, you can sort of see elevations up and down throughout the trail and make sure you're going in the correct direction, which is always important.
Yeah.
And as well, you can just sort of get an idea of deeper pools for this as well.
Nice. Something else that I had done is I ordered a map of the region from mytopo.com. Where's our put in here?
The put in is right down in the bottom left corner.
Okay.
And we're gonna just go down creek, kind of wrap up and do some loops around the corner here, and just go all the way down. You're gonna cross two different bridges, and we were gonna be taken out at the second bridge.
Okay.
Right there.
So what's our plan of attack? We got both vehicles here with all the boats at the put in. The put in's right down there.
The plan of attack at this point is to drop the boats here, have one person went here and move the largest vehicle to the end of the shuttle so
okay.
that we can then load the equipment and the boats back up and then come back to the start and pick up the first car.
Whenever I get to the takeout point, I like to get my handheld GPS out and mark a waypoint. That way, as we progress through the trip, I have an idea. I can check and see how much progress we've made and if we need to speed up or if we need to slow down. A really good rule of thumb for floating, you know, smaller creeks like this, or even big rivers, is you should plan on fishing at about a mile an hour. You ready?
Yep. Dude, are you sure you have the keys to the takeout vehicle?
Yeah, we're good.
All right, just checking.
And just drift. Oh, he got something. Paul's fishing what I like to call a corner pocket, the end of a pool on either side in the corner. It's a great place for smallmouth to pinch off prey. I mean, it's the terminus of a pool, so it's a place where a lot of food stacks up. I hope you've learned new tricks and tools to enhance your next exploratory trip.
Paul, you want this?
To learn more, get a copy of my book. It's available at BlueRidgeKayakFishing.com. Trip reports can be found at KayakBassFishing.com.